They cleaned up the icons, smooth minimal, and way less clutter. Navigation is snappier. You're not playing hide and seek with your panels. You can tweak the layout easier now. Your graph, viewport, and content browser all at one monitor. Like a mad scientist, then do it. Honestly, it just feels better. Nothing wild, but smoother workflow. Now here's the part that surprised me. They didn't just slap default characters in a cube room and call it a day. These templates are actually dope. Let's run through them real quick. Template number one, vehicle template. Perfect if you're making a racing game or just need working vehicle physics without digging through chaos. Suspensions tune in, controls are tight, cameras are included. You can literally start drifting in under 2 minutes. Template number two, side scrolling template. 2D platformers, this one's clean. Jumping, collisions, and basic AI already feels like they modeled it off a Mario Maker dev kit. Template number three, top down strategy template. Camera panning, unit selection, move commands. This one's for the RTS or tactics game devs. With squads, it actually looks like it's a game right away. Good bones. Template number four, FPS template. Plastic first-person shooter, but with working HUD, hit detection, and modular gun setup. Cleaner than the old first-person example nonsense. Template number five, horror template. This one low-key slaps. Lighting is eerie, out of the box, footsteps sounds heavy, interaction systems are pre-built. If you're into horror like Bloodbound, you'll like this. Template number six, third-person template. Your generic third-person base, but better cameras and smoother local motion than before. Think of it like Unreal's version of I Got You Bro.
I got you, bro.
Template number seven, top-down action template. This one mixes Diablo-style view with hack-and-slash combat, has AI that actually fights back, targeting systems, feels good for prototyping. Template number eight, third-person combat template. Now this one's spicy. Combos, animation blending, login system. It's particularly a Souls-like base. It's clear they want folks to build real combat games now. So yeah, 5.6 is more than a polished patch. It's a real update for devs who want to start projects without spending 2 weeks wiring up input mappings and reinventing the jump button. Got a favorite template? Let me know why and drop a comment below. And if you want to get access to early tutorials, source files, and private dev chat, join my Discord. It's growing and I want you there. And if you're serious about optimizing your game, click on the video on the right. I'll talk all about hitches, performance killers, and how to make Unreal run smooth on a potato.